In this video, I'm just going to go over more examples using the formula for slope to compute the slope of a line if you know two points on the line. So remember, if you have two points, let's call it x1, y1 for one of the points and x2, y2 for the other point. The slope is the difference in the y values over the difference of the x values. Notice you have one ordered pair with its y over x here. And the other ordered pair with its y over x after the minus sign. It does not matter the order. You could have the first point sort of minus the second point or the second point minus the first. But you don't want to switch and have like y2 over y1 and then x1 minus x2. That's not going to work. Remember, it's the y over the x, and in each column, they sort of go together. So here's the first problem. Find the slope of the line containing the points 8, negative 5, and negative 3, negative 2. All right, so what we're going to do is start out with the formula for slope, m equals, you do the fraction bar, two minus signs, and I'm going to take one of the ordered pairs, 8, negative 5, and put it as y over x, and then the other ordered pair. This is just a little trick to remind yourself which goes where, but you don't have to write that out. So I'm going to put y over x in this first one, negative 5 over 8, and then y over x in the next one, negative 2 over negative 3. Remember to put the minus signs there for the negative 2 and the negative 3, put the negative signs. That's not part of the minus sign in the fraction. All right, now we need to simplify this. So let's see. This will be plus a positive, and that'll give you a negative 3 for the numerator. And in the denominator, it's going to be a positive. 8 plus 3 is 11. And so it's negative 3/11. Now, let's not really graph it completely, but see if this kind of looks like it might be correct by approximating where these points are. 8, negative 5. Let's say 8, negative 5 is somewhere down here. Okay, and negative 3, negative 2 is somewhere over here. So approximately, it looks like the slope should be negative, because it's slanting the right direction. And also, 3/11 is a small number. That means it's getting close to a flatter line compared to a really steep line. So remember, a horizontal line has a slope of 0. So this isn't quite 0, right? But it is sort of flat. So that seems reasonable that that's the correct answer. All right, let's do another one. All right, how about if we were doing it between the points, a line going through 5, negative 7 and 5, 2. So let's take the first order pair, like 5, negative 7. We'll put that here, y over x. And the other one, 5, 2, we'll put it here, y over x. So let's put negative 7 over 5, right, the y over x, and then 2 over 5, the y over x, and compute. So let's see, what do I have here? Negative 7 minus 2 is negative 9, and 5 minus 5 is 0. Uh-oh, what happens when you have a 0 in the denominator? That's not equal to 0. That means the slope is undefined. All right, the slope is undefined. Now, when is the slope undefined? That's when it's a vertical line. Let's see. Oh, maybe this was a vertical line. If this is the x and y axis, let's see, 5, negative 7 is, let's say that's where 5 is, okay? 5, negative 7 is somewhere down here, and 5, 2 is somewhere up there. And yes, actually, if I would have graphed it first, it would have been obvious that it was a vertical line and the slope was undefined. Let's go on to another one. All right, here's another one. 18, negative 11, and 45. Now, here's one where you can see why you might not want to have to get out and draw the picture of that, because you would have to have a pretty big graph to do 18, negative 11, and 45. But let's estimate it. We kind of get a picture. Notice the x values are both positive, so we know it's going to be to the right if I draw a little number line here. of the origin. So if I do 18 negative 11, let's just say that's 18. I'm approximating, right? There's 18 negative 11, let's say. And 45, 40 is way over to the right someplace. Let's just say that's 40. I know it's not really there. And up 5. Well, this looks like it's going to be a positive slope. So that just gives you a little picture ahead of time that hopefully you're going to come out with a positive slope too. So let's set it up. M equals, you have your fraction bar and your minus signs. And let's do the first ordered pair before the minus sign and the second ordered pair y over x after the minus sign. So let's see, y over x, negative 11 over 18 and 5 over 40. So I get negative 16 in the numerator, negative 22 in the denominator. And negative over negative is positive, and then I'm going to reduce this. 2 goes into both numbers, so it's 8 elevenths. So it's almost a slope of 1, and you know the line, hey, it looks kind of close to 1 actually. In fact, at the 45 degree angle, if this is a 45 degree angle, that's a slope of 1 because it means you're going over and up the exact same amount, and that's when the y over x will cancel to 1 over 1, so you have a slope of 1. So this seems like a reasonable answer. Here's another example. Negative 1, negative 3, and 1, 5. All right, so we're going to do the same setup. And let's put this before the minus sign, y over x. Negative 3 over negative 1. And let's put the second order pair after the minus sign. So I'm going to put that as 5 over 1. Now be careful, the denominator is not 0. This is negative 1 minus 1. Remember that means negative 1 plus negative 1. So what do we have here? Negative 3 minus 5 is negative 8, and the denominator is negative 2. This has a slope of 4. Now, if you get a number bigger than 1, that means it's more of a steep line. So it's positive, so it's slanting up, right, as you move from left to right, and it's also steep. Let's see if that checks out if we did a little estimate of what this looks like. Okay, negative 1, negative 3, let's say that's around here, and 1, 5, that's maybe somewhere up here. Yes, I do get a pretty steep looking line, and it's slanting in the direction that makes it positive. So that looks good. Now remember, you could have switched the order. Let's just do this one more time. It doesn't matter which order pair you put first. I could put the 5 when first, right? Y over x from that ordered pair, and then put the negative 3 over the negative 1, right? The second order pair, y over x. I should get the same answer. So I have 5 minus negative 3 is 8. And 1 minus negative 1, remember it's because of the plus plus thing, is 2. I will get 4. So the slope of this line going through those two points is 4. On this video, I haven't been telling you to put it on pause and try the problems. When you're done, you might want to go back and try each of these problems on your own and see if you get the same answers again. So how about you put the video on pause and try this problem? Find the slope of the line containing these two points, and then, you know, verify it with a little picture that your answer makes sense. Okay, here we are. So I'm going to set it up with a fraction bar, the minus signs. We're going to take the first ordered pair and put y over x, negative 3 over negative 4, and then the second ordered pair put y over x, negative 3 over 2. All right, now what happens here in the numerator? You have negative 3 minus negative 3. I'm subtracting the same number, I'm going to get 0, or go ahead and do the plus plus thing here because you have two minus signs. In any case, you're going to get 0 in the denominator. And let's see what happens in the denominator. I'm saying in the numerator you get 0. Negative 4 minus 2 is negative 6. All right, what's 0 divided by negative 6? 0. Hey, when does that happen? When do you get a slope of 0? Do you remember? That's the horizontal line. So let's see if that checks out. So we've got Let's say the xy axis, let's say I've got negative 4, negative 3. All right, maybe that's, here's negative 4. Maybe that's negative 3 down here. So here's negative 4, negative 3. And then I got 2, negative 3, down here someplace. And yes, that does check out. This is just sort of like a little check to make sure it all seems reasonable. So the slope of this line is 0. All right, so we did lots and lots of examples. You can get the slope of the line by drawing a graph, counting spaces, doing the rise over the run, or using the formula. Really doesn't matter. Just remember to simplify your answer in the end.